Software engineers don't just write code. They follow a proper engineering discipline, and that's how great products get built. Spec-driven development is the missing link that bridges the gap between white coders and production-ready apps. And that's where Kiro shines.
In this video, I'll tell you about what is spec-driven development and what are the benefits of following it. Then we will look into what Kiro best at. And then it is very important to know what Kiro lacks at this current point of time. There are many AI IDEs and how Kiro stands at this. What are the Kiro's weaknesses at this point of time? And then finally, we will use Kiro to build the spec for our production AI landing page. Before we jump into Kiro, we should know what is spec-driven development. So let me move through what I prepared so far. So in a typical company, we have a product managers as well as business stakeholders who give us the requirements. Their requirements are sparse initially, and then they optimize it and then finally come up with all the edge cases, and that is the final requirement. We call it product requirement document, or PRD for short. Once those documents are ready, documents are given to engineering team and the engineering team first decide what all the tech stack they need to have, and then they design the solution first, and that is the system design. Once everything is clear, the final phase is implementation. These days, what we figured out with the vibe coding is, at the end, we found out there is a mismatch between requirement and what was implemented by the AI. So AI keep losing track, and that's why we keep having different variations, and that is not a good way. So to make sure that we have a good AI experience and AI is building production ready apps, we need to follow a structured approach, and that's where spec-driven development really shines. So in this spec-driven development, think in the terms that specs are living documents. They are the source of your source code that are generated by AI. And specs tells you what are the requirements at that point of stage. So AI can always reference those things in the future. So think in the way we have our source code and we generate a binary output, be it a Next.js app, an Android APK, or maybe a C++ binary, but we don't throw away our source code once we have those binaries, right? So similarly, think in the fashion, now AI is writing your code. Does it make sense to scrap away all the specifications, all the requirements that you have given to the AI at that point of time? No, it does not make sense, because AI need those things in future as well. So for that, spec is the source code, is the way to generate your source code, right? And there is a great talk by Sean Grove from OpenAI, where he tells in depth about what spec code really is. And I've been using Kiro for the last 5 days in my organization, and we were able to ship a discount system on the production. And with the spec-driven development, it was very smooth. Watch this video afterwards that I have linked down in the description, and make sure you understand what spec-driven development is. Once you know that, then you will like Kiro for its simplicity and why Kiro shines. Now, let's jump back to Kiro and see Kiro in action. So here I have Kiro opened, where we are creating the production AI landing page. I have initialized manually create T3 stack, which is the Next.js stack for creating Next.js applications. And then I have initialized Ultra Site for formatting and linting purpose. Along with that, Ultra Site have included the rules how to use Next.js properly into the Kiro. Here you can see all the rules. But before we jump into the file structure, I'll quickly show the Kiro tab here. If you see in Kiro, you will see few things. The first is the specs that I talked about just now. The second is agent hooks. We will talk about this in future part of episodes. And then the third is agent steerings. These are the same as we have in Cursor. We call them rules. And again, we have MCP server. Similarly, how we have MCP server in other places, we have MCP server here as well. So here in the Kiro mode, I'll go to the spec section and I can write a prompt here and it will generate the spec specification one by one, right? So I'll copy paste here. So this is all the landing page data that I have written. Initially, I used AI help to write it down for me. So this is my prompt, I'll hit enter. So now as you can see on the screen here on the left hand side in the spec section, it has created a P8 and landing page specification. Now if you open this tab, you will see it has three sections. One is requirement, second is design, and third is task list. Of course, those two are now as of now disabled, because once the requirement is finalized, only then the design and the task list are created. And this is a sequential process. And as you can see, Kiro has written down all the requirement for me. So I have reviewed the requirement.md document that Kiro has created, and it divided the entire requirement into 7 requirement. And I went through each and all those requirement and reviewed it once. And that is very much important for you to do as well. So that looks fine for me, and I did not have any changes in mind as of now. So I'll proceed with that and I'll move to the design section. So I'll click on the move to design phase. It is asking me to validate and run this command. Kiro, you have for the MCP, you either have to trust or you have to run every time. Now, what I wanted to tell you of Kiro lag. One is the context engine. I've used many agentic IDEs, including Cursor, Windsurf, and Augment code, and others as well. But these three are major in terms of my day-to-day work. So what I found, those are very matured and they provide instant context for the AI models, right? So at that point of time, they feel very powerful. But what I felt within last 5 days that the Kiro lacks that much context engine. So sometimes what it does, it duplicates the code that actually harms. And I need to specifically tell Kiro to make sure that you don't duplicate. But again, what I do, because as of now it is using Cloud Sonnet 4 and it is free, what I do, I generate a high level spec in the Kiro, and then I start a task as well. Once the task is done, I mostly refine it with other AI IDEs tool like Cursor or Augment code. Meanwhile, Kiro has created a design doc. I can review it. Okay, let's preview. From architecture, project structure, from what components and interface it need to create, it has created into design doc, along with what all the data model, animation configuration, error handling, everything is there. Similarly, how we reviewed the requirement documentation, how we have to review the design documentation this time. So I'll take a break and I'll review the design documentation. And so I have reviewed the design documentation that Kiro has created. And again, as I mentioned earlier, Kiro lacks the proper context engine as it has in other AI IDEs, right? What I am typing here is that we are using Next.js 15 and React 19. Along with that, we are using Tailwind 4. So I'm asking Kiro that please update these document, design document based on this information. Let me hit enter. Okay, so Kiro started editing. If you don't know what and where Kiro has written it down, you can click on view diff. So if you see, it shows you which lines Kiro has edited. Okay, now I'll diff this as well. Okay, so Kiro added few of the modern framework features as a section in the design documentation. At last, Kiro fixed all the Next.js 14 reference, and it now shows that Kiro has written Next.js 15. Now I am very much happy with the design documentation. I'll go and move ahead with the implementation plan. So I'll click this move to implementation plan. So Kiro has finally created all the tasks, and it has created almost, I think, 12 tasks. I still have to review, but based on my initial review, it looks pretty solid. Anyways, I can always update the task later at the point of time when I feel like it. But again, it is best to know if you are doing a small spec by spec, you should review the task list as well and review it properly. So I'll review the task list and then proceed ahead. So I have reviewed all the tasks. All those 12 tasks look fine to me, and I can finalize the task list. Now I have finalized the task list. It will give me the summary and I can start task one by one. So here it said spec creation complete. And before we start in the next part is you can always git committed. So I'll add git add dot git status. I'll check. Yeah, all the three files. So I have committed all these three files in my Git repository, and this is very important step for you as well. Make sure you also commit these things. Now I'll start the task one by one, and later on part I'll complete all these 12 parts and I'll show you how it looks at the end of this video. So Kiro has completed 9 tasks out of 12, and those 9 tasks helped us create the landing page at first. So I'll open the spec and I'll go to the task list, and you can see that 9 tasks are completed. The 10, 11 and 12 tasks are related to performance, accessibility and final testing on the cross browser. Let's look how the production AI landing page looks like. So I'll reload. So it looks good. It looks better given how much prompt we have given. We have not given much. We have not told what all to put into each of the section other than copy. So on first glance, it looks very good. So this has been done, and this is the about section, and the third section is the featured learning path. Yes, there are few missing parts where it again we have to provide images, and it added all the content by itself, so we can refine those tasks as well. And as you can see, it has an outdated Twitter logo instead of X, so that is one of the improvement we may need to do. Now based on this, I think it is pretty solid based on how much we achieved in 10 to 20 minutes of time. And this looks very good, but again things can be improved, and landing page now these days are very good. But again, what I found way better is all the smoothness with the framer motions are very correct, and it does not like have a jittery effect. I have experience with lot of IDEs in past which does not implement framer motion correctly. Okay, so it is very smooth transition, so it looks good. But again, as I mentioned earlier, we can further improve it down. So I think that's all from my side in this video, and I hope you like it, and thank you for watching. Make sure you leave your comment in case if you have any doubt, I'll be there for you. And if you like, please follow and hit that subscribe button down below, and thank you for sharing all the love. Thank you very much.